just the other day, when Dennis Pratt was lecturing, I interjected something else about property, where I guess the people of subtle mind start challenging you, or you start getting challenges from the socialists in the audience who are ever present in my mind, and I guess Bill Moore is ever present in yours. I'm curious to ask you about that part of your experience. But it's that... Something, a point that George Riesman, who's an economist, made that we all have to agree that historically, at any one point, a lot of property was unjustly appropriated. A lot of land was given. You know, the kings, the princes, they loved to give out land. A lot of legitimate property rights were seized from others. There's a whole welter of unjust actions that you can't possibly unwind or redress. So then somebody might say, well, then how can you talk about legitimate property rights? Riesman's viewpoint, which I think is persuasive, is that the stain is wiped away if you let free market capitalism to operate for a generation or so. The stain is wiped away because my wife owns a building, small building, on Bleecker Street, 5 Bleecker. We don't know. Who did she acquire it from? I mean, it probably was justly built and whoever, but we don't know. But she operates it. She's mixed her labor with it. She has earned the right over time to manage it. In a free market, it falls into the most competent hands, the people who can responsibly manage it, so that therefore we get a replication of that idea of mixing your labor with the soil, of mixing your labor with capital. And I think that's a key point to understand about free market capitalism, again, because we have to cope with the idea that we inherit a history that wasn't clean capitalism, that was clearly filled with corruption.
Let's start to wrap this up.
Okay,
but
sure.
I still haven't had a chance, and I don't know.
Yeah.
How did you discover liberty? What was your gateway drug?
Man, economy, and state.
Yeah.
No, I was privileged that Jeff Tucker actually years ago asked me to do an introduction to a collection of articles by essays by Murray Rothbard called Controversial Essays, 52 essays. And I began the essay by writing, it was nearly 40 years ago that Murray Rothbard changed my life. At this point, it's nearly 50 years ago. And of course, that, as I jokingly said to once when I was, Tom Woods gave me a Gene Epstein week, and Tom Woods said, this is the most irrelevant story to all of you. Who could possibly come to libertarianism by reading Man, Economy, and State? I said, yeah, but it's my story. I was studying economics at the New School. I was teaching economics, and so I was ready to drop out. I was getting soured. Left-wing economics wasn't offering me very much, which is what the New School was serving up, and mainstream economics, which I was pretty much forced to teach in undergraduate school. I had, you know, a teaching job, was also souring me, and I just wanted to quit the whole business. I picked up Man, Economy, and State just a couple of times in the New School library, and then finally read it. So that was my gateway, because it taught me something, of course, which echoes your viewpoint, that really Austrian economists, Austrian economics, is sort of redundancy. That by the way, when the mainstream, when Milton Friedman, who was basically mostly a mainstream economist, but had many insights, or any of them who are mainstream, when they actually just roll up their sleeves and give up the bullshit of mathematics, momentarily forget that they all are whoring after jobs running the Federal Reserve or being chairman of the Federal Reserve, momentarily forget inventing that, which both of which completely taints their discipline, that they want to regard it as a branch of physics to make it obscure, and they basically want to think top-down in order to serve the rich and powerful, in order to serve the interests of the state. Once they forget that, which many of them do, they sound like Austrians. If you read so many of Milton Friedman's better essays, he's sounding like an Austrian. He's basically using simple logic for the way people reason, act in markets, and the markets as a process.